Many years ago, Jason was the leader of the Argonauts, the son of King Iolcus and the rightful heir to the throne of Cephalle. The king's half-brother, Pelias, seized the throne by killing Jason. For his safety, Jason was sent away by his mother. Years later, Jason returned to claim the throne as his own. Pelias promised Jason his inheritance if Jason could achieve the impossible task of acquiring the magical golden fleece from King Aeetes of Colchis. After seemingly endless perils on the sea, Jason and the Argonauts arrive at Colchis, where King Aeetes agrees to surrender the golden fleece if Jason can earn it. The king assigns three tasks for Jason to complete. Jason must harness a fire-breathing bull, plow a field with it, plant seeds, and defeat the dragon that guards the fleece. Medea, sorceress and daughter of King Aeetes, is compelled by the Greek goddesses Aphrodite and Hera to fall in love with Jason. Knowing that the task demanded by her father were ones that no mortal could accomplish, she helps Jason. Medea uses her powers as a sorceress to allow Jason to succeed. Jason and the Argonauts acquire the fleece and make their escape, accompanied by Jason's new lover, Medea. Our story begins in Corinth.
Ghosts, spirits of a world that once filled my mind with visions of the past. Echoes flit through my memory of a brother's laughing face and a father's loving embrace. Visions of home fill me. Night brings no relief, for as I look up at the stars, I hear the song of my people and remember what it felt like once to worship gods who protected us from evil. All is lost. I am left alone with my thoughts in these Greek women who come to peer at me for pity. How I wish the longship Argo had never come to our shores, for then I would have never met Jason, nor loved him. He came to Colchis seeking the golden fleece, and I, with my knowledge of the dark arts, assisted him. For the love of him, I betrayed my father, murdered my brother, and became an outcast.
First, all went well. Jason loved her and was proud of her beauty. Happy is a house where the men and women love and are faithful. Now, all has changed. He calls the old bond a barbarian marriage. He has cast her off, like a common girl, and married the daughter of Creon, the ruler of this land. Jason is free, while you are left to bear the burden of our pain.
To weep for a man who would throw me away for nothing would dishonor me, and all that has been my life. From now until the end of time, no regrets.
Jason would have bettered to tempt a lioness.
He's not wise, I think.
Oh, it's a bad thing to be born wealthy and of noble blood. For when misfortune strikes, it becomes unendurable and drives you mad. I say, poor people are happier. They are used to the misfortune and know to lie low in its wake so that they may survive.
Old servants of Medea, what are you doing out here all alone? Shouldn't you be inside with your mistress?
I needed a moment of solace in the fresh air, away from the grief.
Then Medea's grief hasn't diminished.
No. Her mood is blackened even more.
You must prevail upon Medea to stop crying. She's worse news to endure.
What do you mean?
I have heard rumors that Creon intends to harm Medea.
How? Tell me!
I do not know. A group of old men were talking about her, but when they saw that I listened, they became silent.
This is her domain. She can do what she pleases.
Jason's new wife approaches.
She dares come here? Princess, what an honor. Notice her taut skin. How gracious of you to come to my humble surroundings. Her shining hair and pouting. May I offer you some refreshment?
Medea, this is why I'm here, to tell you frankly why I'm here. I have decided to take fate into my own hands and keep my family safe away from your hatred.
noble name, they can do as they please. Be wary, Medea.
She is as you were, Medea, 15 years ago. Notice her grief.
Her tawny skin is a bitter drug to drink.
How touching. But you are mistaken. The rumors are lies. In fact, I wish you well. I hope Jason is as kind to you as he was to me. That is your wish? Do you curse me? You dare stand there and accuse me of sorcery when it is you who has stolen my husband?
There was no stealing. He came willingly.
All men are stiff after beast and heat.
I am a civilized woman of Corinth. Therefore, I will not stand here and argue with a savage barbarian from a foreign land. I accept, Medea, that you have some cause for your grief, and in this moment of weakness, I will pity you.
Personally, this is why I'm here to tell you that the princess has personally asked me to banish you.
Banish? You know what exile means to a woman of my birth and rank. We would be held in lower esteem than that of a dog in the street. My children are Jason's, who is bound to you by marriage. Why must we be banished?
You will do as the king commands, you witch. He decides your fate.
You are dangerous to me and mine. Jason must forget his past in order to proceed with his future. Farewell, Medea.
Princess, in the middle of the night, when Jason awakes from his terrors, rub his back and kiss that tender spot on his neck. Always remember, I had him first.
You have what is left of the rest of the day to pack, Medea. Don't waste your time with threats. I am alone. Forsaken. Am I to abide by the dictates of others? Or do I defend my honor?
We must. No one will do so in our stead.
Think before we run out of time. Time is relative. It would be good to stand here for 1,000 years and think of nothing. Nothing. But the death of all three people.
I might fail. I might be caught.
Medea, think of your children. Is it possible to annihilate the past without nipping its fruit in the present? Am I to look into my children's eyes forever and see Jason laughing back at me?
Medea, your thoughts are unnatural. It is the thoughts of men that are deceitful. Women must learn to bear the burden and move on, or else their bitterness will destroy them.
I do not know how much misery a Greek woman will endure. But the people of my race are more impetuous.
Learn the Greek way, Medea. Reason over passion is always best.
We will see. We will see.
Where is Medea?
There, mourning for what you have done.
Not I. It is what she has done. It is not by my will, but rather through hers, that she and my sons are to be exiled.
Do I hear a dog?
So, Medea, you cannot keep from making threats against the head of Corinth. You had to tell everyone of your so-called anger and injustices. You could have lived here, happily, well, and secure. But instead you had to go mad with anger and talk yourself into exile. You might have been decent enough to think of the children.
Did you consider them? When you chose to betray this house!
Certainly I considered them. This grievous thing you hate me for. Do you think I did out of boyish fantasies of love and passion?
Yes,
No, Medea! Keep quiet, you will listen! It is not as you resentfully assume that I found your attractions wearisome. Nor do I especially want to raise another family. But by marrying Creon's daughter, I have become his dynast. Thus ensuring that we should live well and not be poor!
You're shameless. If you were honest, you ought to have first won me over. Not got married behind my back. Jason, where am I to go? To my father's side? Or perhaps to Peleus' daughters? Yes, what a fine welcome they'd give for me, who murdered their father. It would have been better if I'd let you die. I poured my magic out for you, Jason.
You drank it like wine, and then betrayed me.
A man dares many things in his adventures. If the gods care for him, they appoint an instrument to help him. You were that instrument. Let's stop this, Medea. Show some sense, woman. Control your passions and come to your reasons. If I would have mentioned it, would you have helped me? No. Your crazed jealousy would not have allowed me to continue. How I long for the days when you were thinking rationally and without this frenzied jealousy would allow.
You better go, Jason.
I came to help and save you if possible. I can provide to meet for the needs of you and the children. Ask, and I will gladly give you what you desire.
Your help is not wanted. Go home to your wife.
Medea, listen to me. To refuse such help is madness. You have everything to gain if you give up this rage. Medea, what is it to be? I have guests in the house and must return to the state's affairs.
Then leave, Jason.
Yours the regret, then.
If I could peel off his memory as easily as he has mine. I hate who I have become. I no longer remember who I am.
Who is Jason's guest?
Aegeus, King of Athens.
My lady knows him. Perhaps he can help us.
King Aegeus leaves for his home today. If he is to help, you can catch him before he sails. Go over.
For our friend.
But why can she not accept what is?
Medea was raised as a savage.
She doesn't understand that a woman's fate was molded by Zeus himself.
Zeus created us to serve, so that from birth we are trained with only one eye, the pleasing of a husband.
As such, our first duty is that of a lover.
We give ourselves to men and we bear children. Then we become mothers, and our duty is to protect the children that will shape our future.
Lastly, in our final years, we become providers of comfort for husbands who seek peace.
We must help Medea to understand this. That may not be possible. Medea is caught in an ancient world that no lone person can escape, set in her ways. It's not easy to make an enemy of her and come off best.
Medea, my lady, Lord Aegeus is here as Creon's guest. I have asked him to come speak to you. Tell him truthfully of your plight, and I'm sure he will grant you refuge.
I have things to do. Be quiet.
We have been banished from here. We must seek shelter.
I am not interested at the moment. Leave me in peace.
No! I held your arms as a newborn babe. I gave you milk. How can I not try and save you? Medea, life is better than death. Help me. Save us.
I am so weary.
Time has a way of settling all troubles. Find peace, Medea. Find peace.
Sunlight bounces up the rafts of spearheads. Aegeus approaches.
Medea, I hope you do not mind that I have shown up unannounced, but your nurse assured me of a warm welcome.
Aegeus, my friend. Many a year has passed since we first met.
How times change us. You wan and pale. What ails thee?
Nothing is wrong. I am quite well. Fools bother me, that is all. Where are you traveling?
I come from Delphi. I went to consult the oracle about begetting a son.
I had not realized you had no heirs. Perhaps it is better, Aegeus. Sometimes, when misfortune strikes, Aegeus, it is bitter to have children around us.
But when death comes, Medea, it is the utter despair for a man to know that his bloodline will not continue. One's children are a gift to his immortality.
Do you feel it so? Then, if you had an enemy you wished to destroy, you'd kill the children first?
I have no enemy I hate enough to inflict such vengeance on. Outliving all of your children would be horrific torture.
My lady, please. Stop. I would not hurt my children. Their father hurts them.
Jason? What do you mean, Medea? Look at me. What has Jason done?
He has allowed for Creon to banish me and the children.
That cannot be. I was led to believe that your separation was amicable and that all was well between you.
Lord Aegeus, my lady is bewildered with grief. If not, she would not ask refuge of you.
She's right, Aegeus. Will you offer me shelter in Athens? I would repay your kindness tenfold. I know of certain remedies that would aid in creating a family.
You tempt a man to madness, Medea. You offer me all my hopes, but at what true price?
Protection from my enemies is all I ask in return.
If you can help me to beget a child, I will shelter you in Athens against all. However, you must reach my lands on your own. I do not wish to start a quarrel with Corinth.
Lord Aegeus, if Medea were not preoccupied, she would gladly thank you for your generosity. We'll soon see. May your journey home be a safe one.
Farewell.
We hear, Medea, you travel to Athens.
May your voyage be fair to distant land.
You see, Medea, life is beautiful and holds infinite possibilities. How can one think of death at this moment? To be alive, to experience the sun's warmth on our skin is beautiful.
As you say, what a marvelous privilege it is to be merely alive. How foolish it is to spend the one day that remains to me in this city full of tears and hatred. Rather, I should reconcile with my enemies. The time has come where reason must overcome passion.
Yes, you have found the path to peace.
Forgiveness is always best.
But how will you convince Creon and Jason that you have had a change of heart?
I can appease them with gold. They say that gold will buy you anything, from friendship to love. So I shall buy theirs. Go to Jason, all of you. Tell him I wish to make peace, and I wish to send his wife some gifts as a measure of contrition. Tell him also that he may see his sons. Go, quickly.
Medea, I fear these turns of events. What are you planning?
Dear nurse, all is well. You will see. Go, quickly. Accompany the women to Jason.
Hatred is here and is heavy to bear. For when love blows away, only hatred remains. Sometimes it is a bitter thing to be a woman. First, an excess of wealth is required for us to buy our husbands, then take our bodies and become masters of that. The great question follows. Will the man we get be bad or good? If the man be good, our life is enviable. But if he's bad, death is preferable. How do we avenge our betrayal? We cannot command armies. A woman is weak for warfare. Therefore, she must use cunning. A plan. A scheme. Remember who I once was. I still am who I was. I am Medea, the bearer of magic. Find a means to pay my husband back for what he has done to me. Direct way. The one I know best. The dark arts will deliver my enemy. That and poison.
If I hadn't known any better, I'd think you were out for blood.
Apologies, old friend. Personal matters should be left out of the practice fields. My mind is elsewhere.
I went to see Medea.
Oh. Did she publicly denounce her feelings for me to you?
She didn't have to. We've been friends a long time.
Why can she not see the advantages of my plan? She won't let herself see past her own jealousy. Women, they judge all in their own intimacies. And if that goes wrong, even the best and noblest of women turn to stone. If only children could be conceived some other way without these females. Without women, human life would be rid of all their miseries.
Jason, hear me. You and Medea have been friends and companions since we sailed on the Argo many ages ago. She has asked me for sanctuary and I have granted it. My one condition is that she reaches my lands on her own. I do not wish to start a war with Creon.
And in return, what do you ask of Medea?
Very well. She has agreed to help with... What have we here?
Medea bids me tell you she has her wits to her again and is willing to look beyond her own woes.
You must excuse me if I'm doubtful.
She offers only peace between you. She wishes that you bid farewell to your children before they depart.
It is truth, Jason. I myself awaiting Medea in Athens. I will foster your sons. All will be well.
I know I have done my best to help Medea. She has refused me. I'm not without feeling. Farewell, old friend. Your help will not be forgotten. I'll tell you plainly, I come not for your sake, but for the children's. Medea, those are King's treasures. Where did you get them?
There's nothing in the world like them. See? The gold almost looks alive. No! Don't touch the gold. It might tarnish.
I want it to gleam for your new bride.
You shouldn't, Medea. Creon's palace has more than enough gold.
One can never have too much gold. Besides, what do I care? I had been saving this as a gift for you on a special occasion. What can be more special than our reconciliation?
Medea, your gifts never come without a price. What are you thinking?
Nothing bad. Jason, exile is a cold and different life for children as young as ours. I thought by sending your wife some gifts, it would aid in their petition to remain in Corinth with you.
You would allow my children to remain in Corinth without their mother.
Better with you than in a cold, harsh world.
Your plan is not without merit. I am pleased, however, that you have changed your mind and regained your senses.
Jason, I ask you to forgive the things I have said to you. It is difficult to forget the many memories of love that we have shared, but when I considered your idea plainly, I saw the wisdom of it. I should have helped you in your endeavors. Truce, Jason.
Truce, Medea. I cannot blame you for what you have said before. It is only natural for a woman to feel jealousy when her husband has a secret love. But understand that it all serves a purpose. My wife, in her state of love, refuses me nothing. I will ask her to allow the children to remain in Corinth. You'll see, Medea, our boys will grow big and strong and become great leaders in Corinth. Why do you weep? Are my words not pleasing?
Yeah, yes, it is nothing. A woman is a weak creature who cries easily. Carry those things to the palace. Then return here. Oh, Jason?
Yes.
If anything were to happen to the children, would you be grieved?
Rest your mind, Medea. I will ensure nothing will happen to the children while in Creon's palace.
Oh, it is good to see that a father will always love his children, even if the love he bears for the mother dies.
Of course. Blood will always be loyal to blood. Don't fret. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must catch up to the children.
Your mood is cruel, Medea, and quite dangerous. What has driven you to allow your children to be parted from you? I fear this.
I saw Jason leaving with the children. Don't give them to him. If you do, he will ache forever.
You have refuge in Athens.
Take them there.
Silence. You heard him. He loves his children. My soul feels as if it is being torn apart.
End this passion and grief of yours. It wastes you away. If your husband is one to new love, why let it anger you? This thing is common.
Stop. The gifts are given. The bait is laid. Soon, Jason's new wife will writhe in the meshes of a poison that will burn so hot, her flesh will erupt into flame.
You have become only darkness and vengeance. Turn back before it engulfs you and survive.
No!
Then I will run to the palace and warn them.
Go! But be sure you do not fall into the same fire.
Let go of me, Medea! I cannot bear it!
You can, and you will. Many of the time your people have called me savage and barbarian. Stay here and watch how the uncivilized will betray you.
A gift from Medea for her peaceful exit.
What a kingly gift this is!
Tell Medea thank you.
What has happened?
Creon's entire house is well pleased. By the time we had entered the palace, everyone had heard the rumor that you and Jason were at peace. She brought the golden gifts into the hall and put them before the princess. At first, the princess turned away and pouted. But when I opened a dark box and a brilliant gold shone up, she marveled at it and smiled. She came away then, before the final spectacle.
Well done. Begin preparing for our departure. The storm approaches. Soon all will be finished.
Medea! Medea!
It is too much. You are horribly avenged. I have stood and watched while you destroyed everything and everyone around here who truly loved you. Recriminations did not pass my lips because of my loyalties to you. But now the naked truth must be examined. Jason never loved you. He used your magic for power and wealth and then transferred those ambitions to another woman. He would have used her as he has used you and then disposed of her also. He is a leech, Medea, and he has bled you dry. Take your children and flee, Medea. Just leave him to the gods.
The gods are dead. I alone am in charge of my destiny, and I choose vengeance.
Jason has not suffered enough. Jason can still say I have lost much. But I still have my children.
I want him crushed, boneless, crawling. My sons are his cubs. They have his blood. As long as they are alive, I shall be mixed with him.
You would murder your own children for jealousy of a marriage bed? It is unnatural for a woman to think of this possibility.
Then what does it make me?
Vengeance comes! Flee, Medea!
Stop! Medea! Let me in! Let me pass! Medea!
Where is Medea? Is she still here or has she run off? Medea!
You have caused these events!
She was faithful to you! You broke faith!
Leave, Jason. Only horrors here.
Enough. I do not want to hear of your recriminations. Simply tell me where my sons are so I may save them from Creon's people. Medea! Medea!
What a feeble nightbird yells at my door. Can this be the great leader of the Argonauts crying at my steps?
Stop, Medea. Simply give me my son so that I may save them from Creon's men.
They are sleeping. The hour is late. You ought to go home to that highborn wife of yours. Surely her burnt flesh doesn't offend you.
You're vile! I'll kill you first and then find my son!
Remember who I am. Touch me, and I'll make you what your wife and Creon are. Let him see his sons.
Committed this horror!
I have done it.
Why?
Because I loathed you more than I loved them. I tore my heart out and laughed while I did it because I was tearing yours out at the same time.
What a wicked mother you are! Why?
I love so small a pain, do you think, for a woman?
You are wholly evil! You're a monster and wholly evil! Will you laugh as I strangle you?
I would still laugh. You are left childless, helpless.
Alone. Tell me, Jason, was your betrayal worth all this?
What does it matter now? There's nothing left. Go! Leave before Creon's men find you. I have a bride to bury and sons to mourn for. Just let me touch my dear boy's flesh before we are overrun!
No! They are mine.
Besides, you might sell their bodies for silver or power.
The curse of your children! Blood be on you!
Oh, Jason. We were cursed the day we destroyed my family for gain. This is all clearly the culmination of it. Let us leave this place of betrayal and find a place where the sun may shine gently on the graves of my children and where I may rest until the Erinyes come to seek their retribution.
Thea, don't you feel any guilt? Any shame?
Do you? Farewell, beloved.
In this instance, no one is the victor except death. In the name of vengeance, justice is served.